Hi, this is Joseph Anthony, the Wonder Child Blog. Thank you so much for stopping by. Today we are going to do an EFT tapping session on moving through, or maybe better said, moving with grief, sadness. And this is unspecified grief. Obviously, I don't know what your situation is. So it's just any sadness. It could be sadness from decades ago. Could be generational sadness that's just in your DNA. Could be grief from last week. Any grief that you're carrying. Big, intense grief. Low level, but grief nonetheless. Whatever the intensity or cause. This isn't to address the causes of the grief. It's just to enable and guide us through and with the grief. To give ourselves permission to be in that place of grieving. And some of you may say, why on earth would you want to help us be sad, Joseph? Sadness is one of the human emotions. And it is just part of the human experience. Some of us have trouble being in our grief and sadness and instead lash out. And maybe it becomes anger or rage or intense fear. If we can support one another in grieving, feeling the feelings we have to feel, well, the quicker the transformation into the joy can come. So, when I do the setup phrase, by the way, I'm not going to do the traditional, even though I'm feeling grief, I love and accept myself, because this isn't an even though. It's, today I'm feeling sad, and I love and accept myself, kind of thing. You see the difference, yeah. So, anyway, if you choose to tap along with me today and sing with me today, you are accepting full responsibility for doing so. All right, let's get started. Today I am feeling sad, and I love and accept myself. Today I am feeling a lot of grief, and I love myself. There is so much sadness welling up within me. And I love myself. There is so much pain inside. And I love myself. Today I am choosing to feel the sadness. Today I am choosing to feel the pain. And even though a part of me says, oh, it will never stop, if I feel the grief, it will never stop. It will stop. And even though there is no finish line to grieving, I choose to feel my grief today. My tears are sacred things. As the poet Khalil Gibran once said, something magical about our tears. They carry the same salt that's in the sea. Today, I move towards the pain. Today, I allow myself to gently embrace my grieving. To allow my tears to purify me if I need it. Today I choose to sink deeply into the embrace of sadness and let my tears flow like a river. And if I need support through this process of moving through and with my grief, then I will make healthy, appropriate choices. And find people I can trust. And allow them to witness my grief. And if I have any thoughts that it is a shameful thing to cry, and if I have any voices within me that say, big boys don't cry, or big girls don't cry, I choose to let those voices go. And perhaps I choose to consciously change those voices so that they may say, everyone cries. The strongest of the strong. It is not only okay to cry, it is human, it is divine, it is as much part of me as the rain in the spring. Today I choose to let the tears flow and water the garden of my heart. I choose to embrace the pain. And if there's any part of me that's afraid that once I start grieving, it will never stop, I choose to let that go. My grieving is wise. It will stop so I can make dinner. It will stop so I can go to work. It will stop. And it's okay. For it hasn't gone anywhere. Like a river that goes underground for a while. River of tears still there. So today I choose to grieve without judgment and let the tears flow as they will and let the tears cease and pause as they will. Today I choose to let go of any judgment that I'm suppressing or repressing my grief if it should stop or pause. It's okay. There are no rules in grieving. There is no way to mess it up or do it wrong. Today I choose to let myself become a puddle if I need to. Sun reflects in puddles. Birds of spring bathe themselves in puddles. My tears are healing. My tears are holy. And right here and right now, I give myself permission to grieve, to move through and with my tears. And if I want to channel those tears into creativity, then I will. If I want to cry alone, I will. If I want to find someone to cry with, I will. There's no right or wrong. Today I choose to honor my grief, to embrace my pain. My tears are holy and sacred, and I let them flow freely, right here and right now.